hi and welcome to another video. So this is barbel and chub fishing on the River Severn. So some of you will have seen some of my videos from last year, and one of them was about fishing the River Trent, and I fished the three main areas, the upper, the middle and the lower. Now this one is basically the same principle, but it's a River Severn, so I'm going to fish the three areas of the Severn and share the footage on this video. The one learning from the Trent video was I tried to fit too much into the video, try to show like everything almost, and it ended up being an hour and a half long, which is a bit too long. So this one's gonna be a bit more of a highlights, so I'm gonna try and keep it to no more than an hour. But what I will do is I'll release some of the sessions in their entirety with all the footage as separate videos. So that's it, so that's what it's all about. So I'm gonna stop talking and get on showing you the footage of me fishing. Cheers. So I'm gonna try this swim and see how we go. I'll show you the swim. So this is the swim. We've got a nice bush on the far side over here, and my right hand rod, which has got the feeder on, is being cast over towards that bush. Though casting is quite difficult, I have got trees above me, so it's a bit of a side cast, which is not easy. And then this one is fishing sort of downstream, probably only about a third of the way out, but there's a decent flow here, about a third of the way out anyway. So so that's the plan. Let's try a different swim and see if it makes any difference. So yeah, hopefully I might catch you a bit later with a fish. Finally we have a fish, not very big though. Not really what we're after, but it is a fish. Very acrobatic fish. Yeah, not really what we're after. So I lost a fish earlier, which I think was a chub, quite near the net. It felt like it was about a 2 or 3 pound chub, and then I've just had this one. And I've had some cracking line bites on this one, at least three real proper line bites. We have a fish. We definitely have a fish on here. The way it shot off, I would imagine it's a barbel, but you never know. You never know. It certainly shot off. Though it doesn't feel that heavy now, but I'm not sure if it's swimming back towards me now. Feels like it's swimming towards me. Seems to be swimming straight to me. Maybe it's not that big after all. I think it is a small barbel, just saw it. It is indeed a barbel. Right. It's not a... In we go. In we go.
Right, so here's that fish. It's not big. It's not even 5 pound, it's like 4 pound 12. But it's my first upper Severn barbel, and I've waited all day for it, so I'm bloody happy with it. Oh, thank you mate, thank you very much. Right,
similar size to the previous one. Oh no, it's a chub. This one, this is definitely a chub, and it's in the net. It certainly shot off like a barbel, but it's not. It's a lovely chub.
Okay, so this is that chub. It's not big. It's it's 2.5 pound. But still, it's another fish. We've not had many fish today, so it's nice to get a few towards the end of the day.
We live along this. There's houses and cottages along this section of river, and they obviously don't want people wandering around at night, which I absolutely get. but it is a little bit frustrating. Okay, so what looks like a small chub. I think we'll just get this one out quite quickly, I think. I don't think we're gonna... We're not going to be doing any photographs or any weighing, I don't think, of that one. You can see it there. It's what, probably another couple of pound, maybe pound and a half. So this is the plan for today, or the peg for today, should I say. Let's have a bit of a look. There we go. That looks quite nice to me. Looks like there's a bit of cover there on the far bank. Hopefully there might be a few barbel or a few chub over there. I think we might have a fish on this one. Definitely, that's going. And we do. We've not been fishing long either. Probably not even half an hour, I don't think. Now if this is a chub, I'm going to have to watch it doesn't get in down there like it's trying to do, I think. Okay. Yeah, I thought that might be a chub trying to get in down there. A decent sized fish though, I think, in the net.
Right, well here's that chub. Wasn't a bad guess, I said about 3 pound, it's 3.3. It's a nice start to the day.
I'm going to hope it doesn't get into this tree if it's a chub, which it probably is. Here it comes. Yep. It is another chubby. And it's in the net. In the net.
Here's that chub. Not quite as big as the last one, £2.9.
Okay, so here's my rig, 3 ounce running lead, 1.75 test curve rod, 18 mil boilie, size 10 hook, and a PVA bag and a fluorocarbon hook length. Now it's difficult casting into these trees above me. Now to my left, you can see the ground's trampled down. So I'm assuming whoever's been fishing here has done the same as me, sort of walked along here. And you do a sort of side cast, which is not easy, but I think it's the only way you can really do it. So this one's going over the far side. That one's out there. I'm not too close to the bushes, because if it's too close and something picks it up, it'll just go straight underneath. This is the other rod. So this one's got the feeder on, so this one I'm casting a lot more often. Running 2 ounce feeder, it's got soaked pellets and ground bait in it, and it's a size 10 boy, no it's not, it's a size 15 boilie on a size 10 hook. So this one, because there's not really a lot of food content in there, it'll soon dissolve. This one I'm casting a lot more often. And this one's going a bit further down. Like so.
Right, another chub. Similar size. This one's £2.8. So just 1 ounce less than the last one.
We might have a fish. Either that or it's a big line bite, but no, we do have a fish. Right at the death. Right at the death. Literally, I need to be bringing my rods in a couple of minutes because it's just on sunset. We need to be off here by the time it's dark. It's another chub. I would have preferred it to have been a big barbel.
Right, another chub. It's the biggest one so far, £3.4. But this will be the last fish now. I need to pack up as it's right on sunset now and we've got to be off for dark. So there it is.
Right, well, this is the end of the session. I've just had a chub on the right hand rod. I've packed that one away now because we're right on sunset and we need to be off here by the time it's dark. A bit disappointing, really, just the four chub. I quite fancied this peg. I thought nice depth, not too deep, not too shallow, 6 or 7 foot. Bit of cover on the far bank. Quite a nice warm overcast day. We've had a little bit of rain a few days ago. It's dropping down now. It's only probably got 6-8 inches extra on probably, but just a bit of colour. So I did fancy today. I thought this looked like a good peg. But there you go, that's fishing.
Hi and welcome to another video. Today I'm on the Middle Severn. Now I don't know this stretch at all, I've never fished here before. This is a stretch that's on a new club ticket for this season. So yeah, first time down here. I'm quite late getting here, I must admit I'm quite hard to go, I've been quite rushing. My wife was out for the day so I didn't get to leave the house till sort of 6 o'clock-ish. So yeah, it's been a bit of a rush, so I've not filmed myself setting up or anything because I didn't get time. So, and it's now sort of 8:23, and I think sunset's about 8:40, so it'll be getting dark soon. So yeah, so a bit of a rush to set up today. I'll show you the peg. So this is the spot I'm going to be fishing. As I say, I don't really know anything about it. There's my shelter for the evening. Not got the bivvy today, just got the brolly shelter out. The rods are not fishing at the moment. So I've put my deeper through and there's a nice bit of pace on this sort of far side here. And I've got about 6 foot down there where there's a bit of pace. There's not much pacing on the inside here. It's almost a bit of a back eddy here. And it's shallower here. It's only 3 or 4 foot. So I will be casting both rods over to the sort of 3/4 of the way or 2/3 of the way into slightly faster water. I say slightly faster, it's not really very fast, but it's at least it's got some flow there rather than here where it hasn't. As I say, I've got a good 6 foot there. So while I've been setting up, I have been putting out some soaked pellets and ground bait, just like squeezing them into balls and chucking them out down there just to hopefully get fish looking for feed before I actually cast out. I'm going to put a 15 mil boilie on a size 10 on one rod with a small PVA bag and a size 16 boilie on a size 8 on the other rod. Yeah, so that's it, both PVA bags, and I'll be casting out any minute now. As I say, sunset will be with us very soon, so see how we get on. Hopefully see you with a fish or two a bit later.
We might have something on this one. Doesn't look like it's going to be very big. We do have something on the end, but it really isn't very big. Possibly a roach rather than a chub, which I thought it would be. Ooh. Wow, that looks like a big roach. I'll get it unhooked. I might even wait and have a look at that. Was it a bream? Could be a bream, yeah. It's a bream. Ooh! Came off just as it went in the net. So I have got it. Yep, it's a bream. I'm not going to weigh that. Don't know what that is. A couple of pound, 3 pound maybe. Right.
Here's that chub. It's not huge. 3 pound. 3 pound dead, in fact. But still. Fourth fish of the night. Two bream, a roach and a chub. So yeah, there's a few fish about, but just no barbel at the moment.
There's quite a few bats flying about. Here it comes. Is it another small chub, I think? In it goes. Have a look. Oh no, it's another big roach. Oh, that's the second big roach tonight. So if we can just get that in the net. Nearly lost it. It's a very lively fish. Right, there we go. Big roach. Might even weigh that, you know. That's a hell of a roach. GoPro start recording. Wow. We have something at 3:30 in the morning. Could even be a barbel. It's only a little barbel. A little barbel that doesn't want to come up. Give me the run around this fish, is it? Come on. Not that big a fish.
Right, well, here's that barbel. There it is. £7.07. It's not huge, but very welcome.
And we might have a fish on here. This should be another barbel, I would imagine. surfaced for the first time. Here he goes, in that net.
Right then, here's that barbel. Here it is. Nice fish, £8.10. Yep, feels quite heavy actually, feels heavier than that. But yeah, £8.10, nice. Get it back and get the rod back out. Morning, just having my morning brew, contemplating last night. I've had my pot noodle for breakfast. Bit of a mixed night in the end, really. So quite early on, just kind of 9-ish, I think. I had a roach at 1.6, which was a big roach. And then I think it was about 9:30. Had a bream, didn't weigh 2.5-3 pound. And I think it was about an hour later, about 10:30, I had another bream, again, similar size, 2.5-3 pounds, something like that. About 11-ish, I think I had a chub, I did weigh that, that was 3 pounds dead on. And then nothing till about 12:30, when another roach, a big roach as well, 1.11 pound. That is a sizable roach. I was talking to the bailiff actually, and he did say that there's been some big roach coming up, even a few over 2 pound. It was then quiet until 3:30, where it was a proper roaring bite, and that was a barbel at 7.7. Then about an hour later, about 4:30 again, the other rod tore off, another barbel, 8 pound. You can see I've got this sort of fast water here. Now I put my deeper through and I've got a good 8 foot, but even sort of over here when it looks a bit sort of slower, it's still 8 foot over there. So I'm going to be chucking my left hand rod. The rods are not fishing at the moment. The left hand rod is going to be sort of chucked in over here, sort of past the faster water. I've got a 4.5 ounce lead and it sort of settles down here a bit, but it seems to be holding. This other rod, I'm going to just put a little 2 ounce feeder in. I'm going to throw it in sort of into the fast water and let it just trundle down and settle. Now when I put the deeper through, you've got 8 foot, but then there's a very clear sort of bit that goes up, very clear. So I'm thinking that'll be a good place for a bait to settle and probably a good place for fish. So I'm going to try and literally underarm the feeder and let it trundle down to that area, which is just down to my right. Not sure if it's going to work, but that's what I'm going to try. On this right hand rod, I'm going to put pellets and a bit of ground bait and stuff in the feeder, and I'm going to have 2 8mm garlic pellets on the size 12 hook. On the other one, I've got a size 10 hook, and I'm just going to put a size 14 boilie on that one. So boilie on one, pellets on the other, feeder on one, and the other one I'll probably put a PVA bag. We've got one. It's going upstream. It's pulling quite hard actually. Quite hard. I would imagine this is going to be a barbel. Oh, just saw a flash then, but didn't quite see what it was. And comes again. Yes, it's a little barbel. Here he is. Here he comes. There's 2 little garlic pellets sticking out of its mouth. There it is.
Well, here's that fish. Oh,
not a big one. £4.10. But still. Nice start to the day.
Good to get a barbel under the belt already. So we'll get that fish back and get the rod back out. Let's get this net. Not sure it's quite ready yet, but we'll get the net ready. Good account of itself. There it is. Ooh, come back. Come back. Come on. Come to Andy. Come to Andy. Looks a similar size fish to the previous one. Just this one's on the boilie. Whew. Nice. Excellent start now. Two fish in a few minutes. As always, we'll give that a couple of minutes and then we'll have a proper.
Right, here's that fish. It's the second barbel. 6 pound 2. Yeah, not bad. Two fish within a few minutes of each other. So yeah, excellent. Right, we'll get it back.
Yes. Not giving up easy. There it is. There it is, that bronze flank of the barbel in the water. That will soon be my net. There it is. Come on, Mr. Barbel. Into Andy's net. There you go. Lovely, the jubbly. Okay.
Here's that little barbel. There it is. £5.1. That's fairly standard size for here, 4, 5, 6 pound. Another what you call shoal fish. But still, very nice. We'll take that. Right, we'll get it back, get the rod back out.
Okay, this second rod, again running lead. I think this is a 4.5 ounce lead. It's got a size 10 hook, again 9 pound fluorocarbon. It's actually a 14 mil wafter boilie. And a few pellets and broken boilies in a bag. This one's going a bit further out across the water. Casting's a bit awkward actually because there's a tree above me. But that one's going a bit further over there. And to be honest, how many fish have I had? 6. I think there's been 4 on this one and 2 on that one. So yeah, the rod further over with the boilie. He's actually out fishing the garlic pellets at the moment. So that's it, both rods recast. Let's wait for fish number 7, hopefully.
Pro start recording. Here we go. Fish number 7. I guess it's probably going to be another small barbel. Or it could be a very big chub.
But there. That bending the rod though is helping to cushion all the surges from the fish. And these rods do have quite a through action, they do bend quite a lot. Good rods. There he is. There he is. Come on, Mr. Barbel. Come on, Mr. Barbel. In he goes, in he goes. Right, quick rest and we'll have a look at you.
Right, here's that barbel. Again, similar size, £5.3. Similar stamp to the others. So what's that now? We've had that's 6 3-5s and a 4. Still, nice fish. You see they've got a good bend in the rod. So, yeah. Thank you, mate. Here he is, fighting, fit, lean machine. The fish that is, not me. Right, get it back.
Oh. Got it out of the snag. Oh, that's another chub. Another chub. I think this is the 12th fish now.
He's that chub. It's the best one so far. Still not massive, it's £3.12. But still, it's not bad, is it? I think that's the 6th chub now. I think we had 6 barbel and 6 chub now. So yeah, chub seems to have come on a bit. Right, let's get it back.
Maybe my clutch is a bit loose. I'll just tighten the clutch up a bit. Ah, no, it's not so easy, is it? Must be a barbel. Must be a barbel. Still not seen it. There it is. Thought it would be a little barbel. Come on. Come to Andy. There you go. Have a little rest. And then we'll have a little look at you.
Right. Here's another barbel. £5.8. They're not the biggest, but still. I think this is the 6th or 7th barbel. I'll have to look on my phone now, I've lost track. But yeah, nice fish. Right, we'll get it back.
So, we've got another fish on. I'm literally just starting to pack up. In fact, I wasn't even looking. I was facing the other way and I heard the line go. I'd imagine it's going to be another similar sized barbel by the feel of it. This will probably be the last fish of the day as I'm literally about to pack up. See, flashing in the water, it is another barbel. This is the 8th barbel of the day. But not many have come on this rod. This is the one with the garlic pellets. Most of the fish have come on the boilie rod. It's nice just to get one at the end, hopefully, on this one. Come on, Mr. Barbel.
Come on. Here he goes. In that net.
It's probably going to be the last fish of the day. I've not actually weighed it. It looks like, again, it's another 4 or 5 pound. But yeah, I'm not going to bother because I'm literally just starting to pack up. So yeah, I'm just going to get it back anyway. Last fish of the day.
Right, well, that's the end of the session. I've done 7 hours, caught 15 barbel and chub, 8 barbel, 7 chub, plus the roach, plus I lost a fish in a snag. But nothing big. Biggest barbel was 6'2", biggest chub was 3'12". So quite a few small chub around 2 pound that I didn't even weigh. Quite a few barbel in the 5 pound bracket. But still, a very enjoyable, very entertaining few hours on the river. Not fished this peg before, so I wasn't quite sure how to attack it. My left hand rod with a boilie on, which I was chucking into the slower water on the far side, picked up the majority of the fish. That certainly was the spot. The other rod, I tried moving that one around quite a lot. That one I had the 2 8mm garlic pellets on it. And I tried it an underarm in quite close. I tried a bit further, I tried further downstream. I couldn't really find anywhere where it really worked. I mean, I picked up a few fish on it, but not many. Welcome to another video. Today I'm on the Lower Severn. It's late October, but it's still pretty warm. It's still about 15, 16 degrees at the moment. Bit of rain forecast overnight, so it's 4:30 in the afternoon now, so I think it's dark at 6 or sunsets at 6. So I'm gonna get myself set up, then I'll come back and talk to you about how I'm gonna fish today.
Right, so now I'm all set up. It's taken a bit of a while, to be honest. It's 5:30 now. I think I said earlier, sunset's at 6 o'clock, so it's going to start to get dark soon. So I'm all set up though. I've put my Deeper Pro Plus through. I've got 10, 11 foot out in the middle, and I've got an idea where it starts to slope up into the slightly shallower water in close. So I'll show you the swim. So my plan is to put one rod sort of out in the middle, where it's, as I said, 10, 11 foot. And the other rod I'm gonna put sort of down here somewhere. It's difficult to get this right on the camera, down here somewhere. So the aim is to get it just at the bottom of the shelf. And I think fish hopefully will patrol up and down there.
This is what I had on my Deeper. So it was about 10 foot, slightly deeper in some places. Then just here, you can see, this is where it started to shallow up. And this is, you know, just here is where really I'm trying to get that luncheon meat. You can see actually the GoPro saw a few fish there, and then it comes back up till it gets quite close in. Then I put it out again, and you can see 10.8 feet, 10.9, and then it looked like there was a few fish on the bottom. And then again, brought it in, and you can see. Then I had a third go, and again, you can see there. And it actually looked like there was some fish up the bank as well. So if it lands here, great. If it lands somewhere along there, that's fine, because I think fish will probably patrol along there. So yeah, that's one of the good things about a Deeper. You can find where the drop off is and where it sort of levels out.
Oh, looks like we might have a fish already. We have. I don't think it's going to be very big. And last time I was here, I fished a bit further up about 6 weeks ago, and I had 11 chub. That's all I had, was chub. And this wouldn't surprise me if it's not a chub. As suspected, chub. Hope I'm not in for another night of chub.
Right, well, that's a quick start. The rods have not been out very long, and we've already got a chub.
not a big one. It's £2 exactly, that chub. There it is. But rods have only been out about 15-20 minutes.
Yes, I can feel what I'm guessing is going to be another small bream. Oh, yes, there it is. Another bream, just what you want in the early hours of the morning. Not.
Well, that was a bite and a half. Piece of meat, so and that was really shot off.
Get in.
Right, so here's that fish. It's not quite a double. Lively, keep still. Not quite a double. £9.12. Nice though. Certainly gave a good bite. It absolutely tore off with that big piece of luncheon meat. Yeah, nice fish. There we go. Right, let's get it back anyway.
Right, that barbel has been resting for quite a long time. There it goes. Thanks for popping in. Still going, still going. There she goes. Got an old bream. Here it is. Another bream.
Morning. Well, fishing has been abandoned. It's absolutely chucking it down with rain. My bivvy's leaking. The river's rising. And I'm a bit concerned that where I'm fishing is going to be underwater soon. I'm fishing on this little bit of land that's sort of down the main bank. So yeah, with the rising river and the rain and my bivvy leaking, I would have been packing up in a bit anyway, but yeah, I think it's definitely time to go. So I had one chub early on that was £2, four bream and one barbel at 9.12. So yeah, would have liked a few more barbel, but there you go. Anyway, I'm not hanging around, I'm getting off. See you again, cheers.
Right, well, welcome to another video. I'm on the Lower Severn. I actually fished here last week, just about 30, 40 yards further up over there. I'm gonna fish here today. You can see, hopefully the weather's not bad. In fact, it's very mild for this time of year. I think it's been about 18 degrees today and it's the end of October. And it's gonna stay, I think it's gonna go down to about 13 overnight. So pretty good weather for it. We'll get my barrow down this hill, hopefully without any mishaps. There we go. And this is where I'm going to fish. I'm going to put my bivvy here, and then I'm going to put my tripod sort of here. I'm going to fish one out in the middle where I know it's about 10 to 11 feet, because I said I fished just a bit further up there last week. And the other one I'm going to put a piece of meat on and chuck it not quite as far, but you know, a third of the way out maybe. So that's going to be the plan. Right, it's 4:30, so time's getting on, because I think sunset's 5:45. And I've got to get set up and get my bivvy up and everything. So I'm going to get set up and then I'll come back to you in a bit. Yeah, it's a bream, I thought it would be. There we go. First bream of the night. Hopefully the last, but I doubt it. Right, oh, God, the other one's going. Stay there, Mr. Bream. I don't think this one's a bream. I don't think this is a bream. Oh, definitely not. Jeez, this is not a bream. Well, that's certainly shot off. This is the meat. So sorry, Mr. Bream, it's still in my net. But I can't unhook you whilst I'm playing a barbel. Oh, you just surfaced out there. I'll just give a, I think just a slight tightening of that clutch. It's getting close. It's getting close. There it is. It's here it comes. Sorry, Mr. Bream, but you have to share the net with a barbel. Here it comes. Here it comes into Andy's net. Get in that net. Oh. Whew. Now we've got a bream and a barbel. So I'll obviously unhook that bream quickly and let it go. And then we'll get a better look at that barbel. Right, so here's that barbel. Decent fish, it's a double. In fact, I think it might be the biggest I've ever had from here. It's £10.14. That's a good fish. You can see, £10.14. And the night's young, caught that on the luncheon meat. So yeah. Another bream. Oh. Okay, another bream. So we'll get that unhooked and get the rod back out. I'm sorry, Mr. Swan, but I've got a fish on the end. It's a barbel. Was it a bream? Oh, I don't know. It's a small barbel, I think. In the net. There you go. A little barbel.
Right. So here's that barbel then. Not a big one. £5. £5.09. So yeah, not a big fish, but still very welcome. Second barbel of the night. Right, well, get it back anyway. Get the rod back out.
Right, well, it's now sort of 12:30. So far we've had, I think it's 6 bream and 2 barbel. Obviously a good double at 10:14 and the smaller one at 5:09, which was not long ago. So, yeah, not a bad start. Of course, the clocks go back tonight, so we'll get an extra hour. So I've just recast the rods now at 12:30. And I'm going to lie here on my bed. I'll probably doze a little bit, but the alarms are on. So, yeah, I'll soon get there if they go off. So, yeah, so hopefully I'll see you again with one or two more fish during the early hours. Catch you later, hopefully. We might have a bite on this one. Ooh, I think that's possibly a fish. And this is the luncheon meat rod, so yeah, you would imagine this will be a nice barbel. Let's just move over here a bit. Keep it coming. And it's still taking line. It feels like it's got me snagged actually. Let's I'm gonna change of direction. Oh no. Well, we've still possibly got a barbel on the other rod, but that one's still snagged. And I've not managed to move it. But now it feels like I've got a barbel on this rod. Unfortunately, I need to move down here. I've left the net over here for this one. Oh. I think the other one, is still possibly on, but I think it's snagged, so I'm not sure I'm going to get that one in. I've left it to see if it manages to pull it out itself. But here we are. We've got is it a bream on this one? Right. No, it just looks like it's a big bream, not a barbel. A bigger bream than the previous ones. Oh well, there was me thinking I had a barbel on it. Yeah, that's quite a big bream. Might even have a look at how heavy that one is. Unbelievably, this fish that was snagged before I caught that bream, I've walked right along the bank at the top, as far as I can go, and I've managed to get it moving. Can't believe that. It's been on for about, I don't know, 20 minutes. But I managed to get it moving, and here it is. That's amazing. Can't believe I managed to get it moving. But there you go. I did, and there it is. Get in that net. That just goes to show sometimes, change the angle. And believe me, I changed the angle a lot because I had to walk right down there. You can't even see as far as I walked. And I managed to get it moving. It's not even a big fish, but still, I'm very happy to have caught it. Right, so we'll give that a little rest and then we'll have a proper look at it.
Right, well, here's that barbel. This is the one that was snagged and took absolutely ages to get. It's £8.5. So, not a bad fish. Very lively one, but yeah, nice fish. There it is. Right, we'll get it back, and both rods are out now because the bream on one and the barbel on the other. So to get both rods back out, and it's 2 o'clock in the morning.
I can feel it fighting away. It's still coming. Come on, come to Andy. Must be getting close. Now it did go an hell of a run. Is another barbel. Another barbel. Come on. In that net. Ooh, here we go. We're in. There we go. That's a decent fish, I think. Right, well, we'll give that a few minutes to recover and then we'll have a proper look.
Right, well, this is a good fish. There you go, £11.3. This is actually my River 7 PB. I've not fished the 7 that much over the years, and yeah, I've had some doubles. I had one earlier, but yeah, this is my biggest, £11.3. I know it's not a massive for a PB, but it's my River 7 PB. So yeah, pleased with that. Very pleased with that. All right, let's get it back and get the rod back out. See if we can get a bigger one.
Well, I think that's gone back. Morning. Just having my morning coffee, contemplating last night's session. Pretty good session really overall. Ended up with 12 fish, 8 bream and 4 barbel. One bream was biggish, £7.2. All the others I didn't weigh actually. They were all, I don't know, 3 or 4 pound, I guess. But the barbel, 2 doubles, 11.3, which is actually a new PB for the River 7. I know it's not very big, but I've not fished the 7 much over the years. A 10.14, an 8.5 and a 5.9. So yeah, a good session, enjoyed it. It's now sort of getting on for 8 o'clock in the morning, so it's time to head off home. I've had my pot noodle. I'm just about to start breaking down my bivvy once I finish my coffee, and then I'll be off home. So cheers guys, hope you enjoyed the session.